1 Peter 5:8 says, "The devil is seeking whom he may devour." Join Don Allen as he looks to make you undevourable.
Thanks for giving me 7 minutes of your day to help make you undevourable. I am your host, Don Allen. I love the story in the book of John. You know, it's in John 8 when they bring this woman who was caught in the act of adultery to Jesus. You remember this, right? In verses 3 through 11 in John 8, it says, "And when the scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, they made her stand in the middle of the court and they put the case before him. 'Teacher,' they said, 'this woman has been caught in the very act of adultery. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such women offenders should be stoned to death. But what do you say to do with her? What's your sentence?' This they said to try to test, hoping that they might find a charge on which to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and he wrote on the ground with his finger. However, when they persisted with their question, he raised himself up and he said, 'Let him who is without sin among you be the first to throw a stone at her.' Then he bent down and he went on writing on the ground with his finger. They listened to him and then they began going out, conscience stricken, one by one, from the oldest down to the last one of them, till Jesus was left alone with the woman standing there before him in the center of the court. When Jesus raised himself up, he said to her, 'Woman, where are your accusers? Has no man condemned you?' She answered, 'No, no one, Lord.' And Jesus said, 'I don't condemn you either. Go on your way. From now on, sin no more.'" What I love about this story is, for one, this woman is guilty. I mean, there's just no way around it. These guys even quote the law to Jesus like he didn't know this. Well, Moses says, and you know, we have a bunch of that stuff today. People trying to accuse someone of something. Well, pastor says, so-and-so on TV said, my mama said. Look, in the end, my friends, it only is going to matter what it is that Jesus says. So they bring this girl and she's guilty. I don't know about you, but I've been guilty of a thing or two myself before. And they bring her to Jesus and said, "So what do we do with her, Jesus? You know what the law says." And I love the posture of Jesus. See, he placed himself between the accusers and the accused. This woman's dirty, sleeping around. Jesus stood right in front of her and he stoops down. Let me tell you something today. Jesus will get down in a mess with you. These guys are locked and loaded, ready to kill this woman. And Jesus gets between her and these men and he stoops down there with her and he's scribbling in the dirt. So these guys keep asking. Jesus finally stands up and he says, "Look, if you've never sinned, then by all means go for it. But otherwise, take a hike." That's my translation anyway. And this woman is hunched over just waiting for that first rock to smash against her head. You know, that's all the world has for you. All they got is guilt and shame, and then they want to turn on you and they want to kill you. Well, by the time it was all over, the room emptied out and Jesus was left standing there before this woman. "Where are your accusers?" "I don't have any." "I don't accuse you either." See, Jesus understood, we don't just throw people away. Every life is worth something. Maybe you're guilty. Maybe you have messed all of this up and the world is right there ready to stone you to death today. Jesus got down there with her, but only for one reason. "I'm getting you up out of here." He didn't abandon her right in the middle of this mess. He stuck with her. She was guilty. She did it, but John 3:17 says, "For God did not send his son into the world in order to judge, to reject, to condemn, to pass sentence on the world, but that the world might find salvation and be made safe and sound through him." This woman already knew that she was doing wrong. Jesus didn't need to beat her down anymore. This is what the religious folks were trying to do, but that wasn't Jesus. I don't know what you heard about Jesus, but let me tell you, this is the truth. We never see Jesus taking those who sinned and those who were down and in a mess and condemning them, shaming them, blaming them, and just tossing them away ever. If anything, he got more upset with the religious leaders than anybody else. But just as Jesus did with this woman, he placed himself between you and death. He took a cross, and the Bible says that he was made sin who knew no sin. He didn't come to reject and condemn and pass any judgments on you. He even said, "I'll be with you in trouble." So the next time that you've blown it and you're thinking, "Well, this is surely it. It's over. I'm done for." Look up. You'll see Jesus standing between you and your punishment. No, it's not an excuse to continue to sin. See, Jesus told her, "Hey, stop doing that. Don't do that anymore." And here's the really amazing thing that happened. Once this woman was forgiven of that sin, she didn't run back to it. She didn't act like, "Man, I got away with that one." No, there's something supernatural that takes place when you have had a life-changing encounter with Jesus. Suddenly, the want-tos change. "I don't want to. I don't want to go back to that anymore." And it caused this woman to follow Jesus for the rest of her life. So how about you today? You done some things that would make you guilty? You know, like, are you looking at porn on your phone? Or how about lusting after somebody? Maybe you're taking drugs or you drink too much. Maybe you even thought about killing somebody. See, what if you were caught in the act like this woman? What if people could see everything that you do and you were caught in the act and brought before the church? "Hey, Jesus, we caught this guy looking at porn on his phone, so what should we do with him?" This woman, there was a woman taking meth, and, you know, we caught her. So what do we do with her, Jesus? You know, I was at a church where an early 20s mama had abandoned her three babies for meth. She came into the church, and of course, everyone knows her business, and everybody was done with her except Jesus. And he had me call her out in front of the whole church and put my arms around this filthy girl. And I mean, she's using sex to get drugs and abandoned her three babies. And he wanted me to stand her up before everybody and tell her, hey, God wanted you to know that he loves you right here, right now, with meth in your veins. He loves you, and you know what? I love you. Is she guilty? Yeah, she is, but you know what? She already knows that. What she didn't know was truth, that she's worth it. She's worth it, and if Jesus was standing there in the flesh that night, that's who he would have sat by, and he would have placed himself between her and all those judging eyes. No, he wouldn't tell her it's okay. He'd tell her to stop it, but he would never stop loving her. So how about you? Maybe you're guilty. Maybe you're right in the middle of some nasty stuff and you know it isn't right. See, this woman was just looking for fulfillment in all that the world has to offer, but she couldn't find it in just any man. No, not until she met that man from Galilee. Today, all you got to do is look up. Where are your accusers? Well, you might have some, but I can tell you who's absent from that group. It's Jesus, because you know what? He's not going to accuse you. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. So you know what? Let's hit that reset button, just like that woman caught in the act of adultery. Let's get up out of the dirt. Let's take Jesus' hand today. Let's walk away from that past, hit that reset button, and make a new start today. And you know what? That's going to make you undevourable. God bless you. I'll talk to you next time.
Thanks for listening. If you would like more information and resources on how to be undevourable, we invite you to check out our website. Go to www.twoguysandabible.com. That's T-W-O, guysandabible.com. You can also contact Don Allen directly for prayer. His email address is don@twoguysandabible.com. Telephone is 573-216-1871.